subscribe if you dare.
Hi, kids. I am slightly concerned that this book is going to give you ideas. Slimy, slimy ideas.
Too late! Already happening!
So much slime from the same family that also used too much glue.
And duct tape, too!
Yeah, these people and sticky substances should probably be separated.
Is there a slime recipe in there?
Funny you should ask.
Please say yes!
Yes.
Yes! Our class will never be the same!
Well, KidTime StoryTime can be life-changing. Let's go! Already I see glops and globs and glue. These people and their glue.
And baking soda and saline! I'm writing this down!
Slow your roll, red bear, pink bear. I think I already lost them.
My family loves to make slime. My dad says slime is stretchy. My mom says slime is scientific. But I say slime is super squishy. Ooh, I shout. I can show my class how to make slime.
You hear that?
Hear what?
Teachers everywhere, trembling with terror.
She might be right. With your teacher's permission, Mom cautions. Remember, Maddie, slime is simple. Just three ingredients, glue, baking soda, and saline. And Dad adds, everything else is just pizzazz.
What's pizzazz, you say?
Isn't pizzazz a large pizza?
No, White Rat, it's this pizzazz.
Ah, yes, a little showtime, showtime.
Pizzazz. That night, I stuff my backpack with all the slime-making supplies I need. Wow, he must have a super-sized backpack.
The next day, my art teacher agrees to a demonstration.
Wait, this is the same teacher from Too Much Glue, and she already forgot about that? Amnesia?
That must be it.
So, I set out everything that I brought, and there he is proudly showing off his supplies, specifically the glue.
Slime is simple, I explained to the class. Just three ingredients. First is glue. At home, we use one bottle, but I want enough slime for everyone, so I'm using six.
Seems like a lot, Maddie, my teacher warns.
Don't worry, I reassure her. I know exactly what I'm doing.
Famous last words.
You took the words right out of my horns. Ooh, look at her. I can tell she's already entering early stage panic.
Bloop.
Next is baking soda. One teaspoon for each bottle of glue.
Then what? My teacher asks so innocently.
Slime is simple, I repeat. Just three ingredients. Glue, baking soda, and I scan my supplies, trying to remember the third.
Oh yeah, pizzazz!
No, 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 wait! According to my notes, pizzazz is not the third ingredient!
Don't worry, Pink Bear. They're about to find that out in approximately 8 seconds.
I know it's wrong, but I'm excited to see the mistake.
Where were we? Oh, yes. Pizzazz! I squeeze in food coloring while Julia stirs. And now comes the best part. We'll knead this with our hands like dough. So I pour a waterfall of slime onto the table and shout, Cowabunga! My teacher shudders like this.
Maddie, is it supposed to spread like that?
What do you think?
Oh no! I shout, I forgot to bring saline! That's what turns this stuff into slime! I can't make slime without saline!
You forgot the saline? My teacher squawks! I don't have any saline!
This is bad.
So bad!
My demo is doomed!
So doomed!
Instead of squishy slime, I'm up to my wrist in icky, sticky swamp! How will I ever clean this up? I groan.
Well, something from the art closet might help, Grace suggests. Well, what could be in there that would help?
Pom-poms look like little mops, Izzy hollers.
Maybe these can stop it up.
Wow,
What a terrible idea!
I love it!
Izzy, Julia, and Noah lob fuzzy pom-poms onto the table, but they just land flip-flop-flip flip, and sink into the spreading sludge. Now I'm up to my elbows, literally, in the icky, sticky swamp that looks like it's just been attacked by confetti.
Sand might solidify it, Luke shouts, dumping in a bagful.
Noah, Caitlin, and Julia dump sand too, enough to turn a swamp into a desert. But the sand creates a swoosh, and soon I am surfing in the icky, sticky swamp.
Look, Owen says, felt letters are like tiny towels.
No! They're not!
It's worth a try!
No! It's not!
Ooh, she's being very negative!
Yeah.
Fine! Let's just toss felt letters into the slimy soup!
Mmm! Now in student flavor!
Which officent?
What?
Tastes like chicken.
Okay, where were we? Oh, yes. Felt letters as tiny towels. Let's see how that goes.
Look, Owen says, felt letters are like tiny towels! Maybe these could soak up the swamp. A... B? Where's the C?
There's no time for ABC order,
Noah yells, and he flings the felt letters at me, whoosh, until I'm in the eye of an alphabet storm. The letters float for a few seconds, but soon
start to slip beneath the surface. Glug, glug, glug.
And so do I. Glug, glug. Glug.
Ah! Ah! Oh no! Ah! Woo!
Now, I'm up to my shoulders in the icky, sticky swamp.
Hey, everybody, Caitlin calls. Haley and I wonder if we could whip this swamp into slime.
So many arms start mixing, but this only makes bubbles. Bubbles. Now we have slime bubbles, and they rise and grow until the biggest bubble explodes. Kaboom! My teacher looks ready to explode now, too.
Maybe she's starting to remember how the last glue experiment worked, maybe?
Because the icky, sticky swamp is landing everywhere. And just then, the school nurse bursts in. Is everyone okay? What is going on?
This is gonna be an interesting explanation.
It's supposed to be slime, I sputter, but I forgot the saline.
Oh, I'm all out of saline, the nurse says, but prizes make everything better.
Do they?
That's just good logic.
Green Bear, it doesn't strike you as slightly inappropriate at this moment?
She's a medical professional.
Fine! Prizes it is. Her prizes add plenty of pizzazz. But I'm still stuck in the icky, sticky swamp. My demo is a dud.
Yes!
A total disaster.
Disaster!
Oh, why did I forget the saline? I wail.
Ah, yes. Wailing. Duds. Disaster. Best book ever.
Ooh! Owen shouts, running out the door.
Where's he going?
I know where to find the saline in school.
No! Come back here! Somebody stop him!
Owen is back in a flash.
Ooh.
Saline from the science lab, he shrieks, and squirting a stream across the room because he couldn't even get close enough. Why not squirt it out like that? And my classmates gasp, gasp, as the swamp magically morphs into spectacular, squishy slime. And everyone helps knead, knead, knead.
Slime is simple, the science teacher recites.
Oh. The science teacher wandered in, must have heard all the commotion. It only takes three ingredients, glue, baking soda, and saline, we all shout. Just then, I see my parents and the principal at the door.
Ruh-roh.
Hi, Maddie, Mom calls. You forgot the saline at home.
I know.
We all know.
But look, my friends saved the slime!
And everyone seems to be having a pretty good time now.
Impressive slime, kiddo, Dad declares, lifting me up into the air like baby Simba in The Lion King. It's filled with pizzazz, pizzazz, just like you. Everyone is amazed.
No, this is perfectly fine. I have to go fix it.
Well, not everyone. We roll the slime around. The big blobs pick up the extra bits, so cleanup is fast and fun. Huh. Soon, our classroom is spotless. Who would have thought? As the final bell rings, my teacher hands out containers. And just as I planned, there's enough slime for everyone. My slime demo was a super success, after all. When we get home, Dad hands me a package. What's this? Read the card, Mom says.
Dear Maddie, use this journal to track your imaginative experiments. I glued in one of my favorite slime recipes to get you started. Yours truly, Principal Stucky.
Principal Stucky? But the last time we saw Principal Stucky, like 3 pages ago, he was in a full-on panic right there. Oh, I'm probably wondering what his boss would say. But then, okay, I guess he was celebrating. And, I see something on the page that I missed. Maybe you caught it, but look down here. Right here, there's Principal Stucky handing the note and the book to the dad while I was, distracted watching the teacher handing out the containers for slime to go. So he sent in a book and a recipe.
Cool, I say. Now I'll never forget an ingredient.
We follow Principal Stucky's recipe right away to make stretchy, scientific, super squishy, glow-in-the-dark slime!
There's glow-in-the-dark slime! Quick, how do we make it?
I put the link in the description. Wait, there's also a fluffy slime recipe.
Fluffy slime?
Let's do this!
Wait, I didn't get to tell him about the sparkly glitter slime.
Oh, I'm gonna make that with my bestie, Corny the Unicorn.
Yay!
And if you want to make the exact slime that Maddie made, there it is, right there in the back of the book. Wait, why does it have fine print?
Sounds like a job for Botticus Finch.
I don't think.
You don't need to. That's why you pay me the big bucks.
I do?
Slime can be difficult to remove from fabric, so be careful not to get it on your clothes.
Too late.
Also, keep slime away from young children.
Good luck with that. I mean, I'm sure we will be able to do that.
And lastly, slime is not edible.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
Fine. More for me.
Storyteller, I'm not gonna name names, but someone made a huge mistake in the kitchen.
I wonder who. That's my cute kid. This is even worse than the book!